friends. This is your host Shree, and in today's show, we have chosen Cricket On Air's World Cup heroes, Wasim Akram, Ricky Ponting, Mohinder Amarnath, and Arvinda De Silva. But no story would be complete without a mention of heroes who go unnoticed or unmentioned, you know. So in this segment of our show, we'll devote our time to some unsung heroes of World Cups.
What three would be an example of an unsung hero?
Unsung heroes are basically people who did really well, who helped their teams go to a reasonable position in the World Cup, but couldn't quite really make it till the end.
Right, and true to that definition, one of the unsung heroes I remember is Lance Klusener.
Exactly.
A childhood spent among Zulu children on a sugarcane farm and 3 years in the army contributed to a straightforward approach to his bowling. He hit the batsman's head if you can't hit his stump.
Wow, that's a good strategy.
Right. Reminds me of the Sehwag thing, right?
Do or die.
See the ball, hit the ball.
Yeah, exactly.
Anyway, so Lance Klusener started off as a fast bowler. He batted at number 11 position. His international cricket started on a pretty bad note, actually, guys.
Right.
His very first test match, Azharuddin hammered him all over the ground.
Yeah, I remember him. He hit him for like 5 fours in one over.
Right. And at that time, that was a big deal.
Yeah. But hey, guys. But Hansi Cronje had faith in his ability, guys. He promoted him to bat at number 3 in some of the matches. And if you know that number 3 is a very critical position. So
oh, yes,
by 1999, he had played a few very crucial innings and was also a very good bowler by then. One of the most respected all-rounders. And one of the things I really found fascinating about that is that in every match for South Africa, he was coming in to bat at the end of the innings and was scoring some really big runs, which becomes very crucial to victory at some of these, you know, matches. And it was unfortunate incidents that he wasn't able to contribute to South Africa's win in the semis.
Another hero I remember of, guys, is Martin Crowe. Martin Crowe started his cricket at an early age of 5 with his elder brother Jeff. The start was quite funny. His brother Jeff was the captain of an under-9 cricket team.
Wow, and do that?
Yeah, they have that in New Zealand apparently. And in one of those matches, they just had 10 players. And they required one more player to make a team of 11. So Jeff asked Martin Crowe to join in the team. Martin Crowe joined the team. But he says that the pads were so big that when he went out to bat, he just kept on falling.
What do you expect from a 9-year-old kid to wear those pads?
Yeah, I'm just happy that he was wearing pads being a 9-year-old.
Seriously. Well, moving on, he was 19 when he started and he was thrown in the deep end of the pool to face Dennis Lilly and Jeff Thompson. And he was humiliated, but he came into his own and he was made the captain subsequently. Many believed that New Zealand was the strongest team in 1992 and they were playing like one.
You know, Martin Crowe did get an awesome 100 in their match against Australia. He was brilliant in his performance. And it's quite unfortunate that New Zealand lost to Pakistan in the semis in the World Cup.
But I think Martin Crowe made his mark. I think everyone who saw the 1992 World Cup regarded him as one of the best players in that tournament.
You know, he might be an unsung hero, Shree, but he's a hero in my mind because he was really, really handsome.
Oh my God, there we go again.
You know, I think Deepika, you should have a dream team with Martin Crowe, Wasim Akram, Imran Khan.
Yeah, the dream D team.
Yeah.
In which all the handsome hunks get a spot. That will be my way of celebrating my heroes.